So I went to the wellness show over the weekend, sampling everything from pomegranate juice and chaga chunks to veggie patties and vegan mayonnaise. But a big highlight was watching the one and only Hidekazu Tojo work his magic on the celebrity cooking stage, preparing two dishes unique to the show. Enjoy.
So I'm going to use a saute. This is the whole same, you know, process. But this is very important.
The size of the portobello mushrooms?
Soaking is a salt or soy sauce, you know,
soy sauce, yeah. For 5 minutes.
Because it's a mushroom very, you know, strong, yeah?
Yes.
So when you saute, you know, oil, sucking it on all the oil, very greasy. But today is a little bit rush. Just like this, you squeeze.
Can you guys see what he's doing there?
Squeeze, you know, the mushroom.
Squeezing all the soy sauce out of the mushroom.
Very tasty. Texture and not oily.
So Tojo, every year you come, you make something totally different from the year before. So tell us, what is inspiring you this year?
Because people now are very concerned about the healthy.
Healthy.
Not only taste. So that's why now people are looking for Tojo, what is the new. I said, so I met his player, you know, quinoa supplier. So Tojo, you're challenging to quinoa. Oh, I like it. I like to challenge it. But the quinoa is not sticky together, but they did it together, stay together.
Yeah, this is really interesting, this product. It's a Canadian product. It's quinoa that was grown in Saskatchewan, processed here in British Columbia, and manufactured for Tojo at BCIT, so they've actually put more starch into it, am I right? To make it sticky, so it basically is exactly like sushi rice, only it's like sushi quinoa. So right now, Tojo is the only one who's using this product.
Yeah, right now, you only reuse. So I think he's spread it all over.
He's going to spread, and you're going to help us spread it all over. You're going to taste it, you're going to love it, you're going to go to Tojo's restaurant, sample it, and then before you know it, it's going to be available at your fingertips to use at home. Am I right? Totally.
We started almost 6 months ago. Every night, many people are
asking. Is that right? Yes. Has anybody had it at Tojo's restaurant? He's been making sushi with quinoa for about 6 months. Well, now you all know where to get it.
I think it's not only local, people, you know, ask me, you know, all over.
For tourists, yes. Yeah.
I think that this quinoa is going to spread it all over.
Absolutely.
Very soon.
And we love Canadian products.
Yeah.
We love products that we can say are, you know, processed or manufactured right here in our own backyard. And BCIT is clearly doing fantastic things.
So last year, you know, Canada 150.
Canada 150.
Yeah, you know, anniversary. Eh?
Yeah.
So many people told you, can you make something different?
Special.
So I made it a quinoa.
So this is in celebration of Canada's 150th. Yeah. This is a special creation.
So I like this. This is, I put it already in my mouth, but I like to steak too. So tuna. Don't overcook. Just
what's the secret in not overcooking your tuna?
Because it's a high quality. Of course, you can eat it for sushi sashimi. So, but I like to texture two sides. With outside very harder, you know, texture. And the inside the moist. Yes. So, and we're going to make it a sauce now. This sauce, soy sauce. Remember, one soy sauce, one mini Japanese cooking wine.
Now you're not measuring anything, so.
Yeah, I don't want measure, so that's only you need little bit reduction.
And is it equal parts soy sauce and equal parts Japanese cooking wine?
Yeah. But if you have no cooking wine, just white wine.
White wine.
Then little bit add this minced garlic. Maybe little bit butter.
We're still being healthy though.
So then slowly melting. Meantime, I'm going to make this maybe I need to put this avocado on the top.
Oh yes.
Anything, you can put this old seasonal vegetable, but the tuna and avocado is very good combination.
What would you say is your most popular roll at the restaurant?
Right now, we call this golden roll.
The golden roll. What's in the golden roll?
That's it. Golden roll is, we don't use no seaweed, but some people don't use the seaweed. Okay, we make it an egg plate. And ingredients all West Coast, you know, salmon,
avocado,
crab, and
smoked prawns,
and scallops.
And scallops?
Yes.
Wrapped in an egg crate?
Egg plate.
Oh, that sounds delicious.
So, sauce is already, but before I like to put this at
beautiful.
Tuna and a portobello mushroom steak. It's very tasty.
Albacore tuna and portobello mushroom steak.
Okay, we're going to now quinoa.
Quinoa
roll.
The quinoa roll.
Yes. So, usually I show you quinoa is the quick. I'm going to show you, if you don't get this, I use this rice paper and soy paper.
And soy paper, okay.
I'm going to make now zucchini.
Zucchini, yeah.
I'm going to use zucchini, but I like to hear special, you know, event.
An even so more special demo.
I'm going to make it made by paper here.
You need a good set of knives to do that. Can you guys see this? I want you to do it more under the mirror so everyone can see you. It's amazing.
So, all I show you ingredients here. You know, pickle, cucumber, pickle, asparagus, baby corn, bell pepper, and this is a you know, Indian style hard smoke. So, all Canadian products, then put it all together. So this is all made tempura, very good. And also I use the Tojo special homemade mayo, little bit spicy. So I like to do that. So I like to put this at corner. Kind of a glue.
It acts like glue, is that what you said?
Kind of
like a glue. So this is the special
quinoa,
sushi quinoa. And you can see those starches that they've added in BCIT make it just like a sushi rice. Sticky.
Salmon.
You haven't cooked the quinoa any special way, have you?
Quinoa is just like plain rice.
Like plain rice.
Yeah. More short time. It's just only 10 minutes. Very easy. Quinoa is very easy to cook. So I put it up for me. Mayo. And bell pepper. Asparagus. And baby corn. I'm vigorous.
It looks like a big roll. And then you roll it. What is the trick in creating the best sushi roll?
Best ingredients.
Best ingredients?
That's very important.
That's the most important.
So, I think that many people say, oh, what is, I think 80% buy best ingredients. Then you can make it a good food. So I like to cut this now.
He makes it look so easy, doesn't he? This is totally not fair.
Okay, if you eat chicken, fine.
With the chicken, anything you want.
Anything possible.